Laudetur Jesus Christus, and welcome to the celebration of the recitation of the Angelus with the blessing of our Holy Father on the feast of the solemnity of St. John the Baptizer. Thousands are gathered here in St. Peter's Square, watching that window that we now see at the top of our screens, waiting for His Holiness Pope Francis to appear. We will first hear some words reflecting on today's gospel regarding the birth of St. John the Baptizer, the precursor. I'd like to welcome all of you who are joining us for today's live broadcast. Those of you joining us through Vatican News and other Vatican News channels. Those of you joining us on television through Catholic TV, EWTN, Shalom World TV, as well as all of you joining us through other radio channels and internet sources. On behalf of all of us at Vatican Media, a warm welcome to you all as we too now wait in anticipation for our Holy Father to appear and to recite with us the Angelus, a prayer that allows us to remember one of the primary truths of our faith and to hear once again what great joy it was for the Heavenly Father to announce through the angel the birth of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. It's a very warm day in Rome. We can now hear the crowd awaiting our Holy Father in the piazza and now appearing at the window.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno. Oggi la liturgia ci invita a celebrare la festa della Natività di San Giovanni Battista.
Today, the liturgy invites us to celebrate the feast of the birth of St. John the Baptizer.
Che illumina la vita dei suoi genitori, Elisabetta e Zaccaria.
His birth is the event that illuminates the lives of his parents, Elizabeth and Zechariah, and is a source of great joy and wonder for relatives and neighbors. These elderly parents had dreamed and prepared for that day, but in the end, they were no longer waiting for it. They felt excluded, humiliated, disappointed. They didn't have children.
Zaccaria era rimasto incredulo.
Faced with the announcement of the birth of a son, Zacharias was incredulous.
Non lo consentiva, non erano vecchi.
Because the laws of nature wouldn't permit it, they were old. Consequently, the Lord took his voice and made him mute for the entire time of Elizabeth's pregnancy.
Ma Dio non dipende dalle nostre logiche. E dalle nostre limitate capacità
umane. But God does not depend on our logic and our limited human capacity. It's necessary to learn to trust and remain silent before the mystery of God and to contemplate in humility and silence His work. His work which reveals itself in history and which often surpasses our imagination. And when the event took place, when Elizabeth and Zechariah experienced that nothing is impossible to God, their joy was great. Today's Gospel announces the birth and then dwells on the moment of the choosing of the name of the child.
alla tradizione di famiglia e dice si chiamerà Giovanni.
Elizabeth chooses a name that is foreign to the family tradition and says he will be called John, which means gift from God. And indeed John,
e questo bambino sarà araldo, testimone della grazia di Dio.
John would be a witness and herald of God's grace for the poor who await salvation with humble faith.
Zacharia conferma inaspettatamente la scelta di quel nome.
Zechariah unexpectedly confirms the choice of that name, writing it down on a tablet. And immediately his mouth was opened, his tongue freed, and he spoke normally, blessing God.
Tutto l'avvenimento della nascita di Giovanni Battista.
The entire event of the birth of John the Baptist is surrounded by a joyful sense of wonder, surprise, and gratitude.
La gente è presa di un santo timore di Dio.
Fear came upon all their neighbors, and all these matters were discussed throughout the hill country of Judea.
Il popolo fedele di Dio intuisce che è accaduto qualcosa di grande, anche se umile e nascosto, e si domanda, che sarà mai questo bambino?
All who heard these things took them to heart, saying, what then will this child be? The people of God were able to live it with faith and with gratitude.
Ma guardiamo quella gente che chiacchierava bene su questa cosa meravigliosa.
People surrounding it were able to speak about the miracle of the birth of John. They talked about it with joy and contentment, with a sense of awe,
con la sorpresa,
at the surprise, and with gratitude. Looking at this, we can ask ourselves, what is my faith like? Is it a joyous faith? Or is it a faith that's always the same, flat, without a sense of wonder? When we see God's works, when we hear things spoken about evangelization, or when we see such good people, do we feel grace within, or does my heart not move at all?
So sentire le consolazioni dello Spirito.
Do I know how to feel the consolation of the Spirit, or am I closed to that? Let's ask ourselves, each one of us, in an examination of conscience, what is my faith like? Is it joyous? Is it open to God's surprises? Because God is the God of surprises.
Am
I able to sense God and His surprises? Do I feel a sense of gratitude? Let's think about these words, which are the soul of faith. Joy, a sense of awe, and a sense of gratitude. May the Blessed Virgin help us to understand that in every human person is the imprint of God, the source of life. May you, Mother of God and our Mother, make us increasingly aware that in generating a child, parents act as co-workers, collaborators with God, a truly sublime mission that makes each family a sanctuary of life. And the birth of every child reawakens joy, awe, and gratitude.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitri.
O digni ficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam quae sumus Domine mentibus nostris infunde. Ut angelo annunciante, Christi Filii tui incarnationem coniobimus, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamur. Per eundem Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Sit pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Ex lux perpetua luce a Teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Esos nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit celum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Amen.
And the crowd reacting now to the words on the blessing of Pope Francis.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, ieri ad Asunción nel Paraguay è stata proclamata.
Yesterday in Asunción, Paraguay,
Maria Felicia di Gesù sacramentato.
Maria Felicia de Jesús sacramentato was proclaimed blessed. Her secular name, her civil name, Maria Felicia Grugiari Echeverria, was a nun of the Order of Descalced Carmelites. Her nickname was La Chiquitunga. Her father used to call her that. She lived in the first half of the 20th century and took up the mission of Catholic Action, taking care of the elderly, the sick, and prisoners. Her fruitful apostolate, sustained by the daily Eucharist, led to her consecration to the Lord. She died, aged 34, having accepted her illness with serenity. The witness of this young blessed is an invitation to all young people, especially those from Paraguay, to live their lives generously, gently, and joyfully. And he's inviting those present to applaud this new blessed and the Paraguayan people.
Rivolgo il mio saluto a tutti voi. Romani e pellegrini.
I extend my greetings to all of you Romans and pilgrims.
Quelli venuti da Hannover e Osnabrück.
Those from Hanover and Osnabrück.
E a quelli della Slovacchia.
And those from Slovakia.
Saluto la comunità romena in Italia.
I greet the Romanian community in Italy.
I fedeli di Enna, Paternò, Rosolini e San Cataldo.
And he's named several cities from which other faithful come.
Sesto San Giovanni.
And the group of cyclists from Sesto San Giovanni.
Auguro a tutti voi una buona domenica.
I wish all of you a blessed Sunday.
Pregare per me. Buon pranzo e arrivederci.
And he concludes as his usual, please do not forget to pray for me. Enjoy your lunch, and we'll see each other again. So ends this beautiful this beautiful weekly appointment of Pope Francis with the people of God, the recitation of the Angelus and his blessing, which all of you have received, as well as those gathered here in St. Peter's Square. Momentarily, a summary of the Pope's Angelus and post-Angelus message will be available at the Vatican News website, which you can reach at www.vaticannews.va. I am Sister Bernadette Reese, and on behalf of all of us here at Vatican Media, I wish you all a most blessed Sunday. Laudetur Jesus Christus.